Today we are going to discuss the subject of AVO with some examples. We are looking for understanding what's going on and what's the idea, the main idea, and how we can use AVO for our study. We will start with this graph, and this graph represents the change of the reflection coefficients with angle. According to this graph, we have four categories. Here is the older, the founder of the one of the founder of the subject. There were at that time only three classes. In the first one, we have the amplitude is high at the zero offset, and the amplitude decrease with angle, with reflection angle, or with offset, until it reach negative values. The second class, and this one represent high impedance. We have high impedance between sand and shale. Why sand and shale? Because this is a typical the typical structural trap, lithologic trap for gas. So we have sand filled with water, with gas, capped or sealed from above and below with shale. So in the first case, we have high impedance sand, and with the angle of incidence increase, the reflection coefficient decreases until it reaches negative value. For class 2, we have nearly zero impedance. It means the impedance of the sand and the impedance of the shale are near to each other. So we don't have here at the zero offset, we don't have high amplitude, and with increasing angle, as you see here, we go to a decrease and we go for negative values. And other one, we have very small negative amplification reflection at the 0 degree and decrease. All the amplitudes here will be negative. And the last class, we have the negative impedance and all the amplitudes are negative. The fourth class, we have the difference. We have low impedance and the amplitude increase with angle of incidence. To understand what is meaning by positive and negative, now we have this interface. we have impedance Z1 for the upper interface and impedance Z2 for lower interface. If this impedance is smaller than the other one, then we'll have same. If Z1 less than Z2, we will have positive reflection. If we have Z1 greater than Z2, we have negative reflection. Okay? What's the meaning? Well, it means we either have amplitude have amplitude in either the positive direction or we'll have the amplitude in the negative direction. So this one is positive and this one is negative, as seen from the variable density representation of the cross section. So if the reflection is positive, the reflector will be dark black or dark blue or dark red, whatever the color we want. So it's dark color. Whereas if the reflection is negative, so we'll have white color. The reflectors will possess white color. So here's the amplitude start positive, and after nearly at 25 degree it becomes negative. In class 2 we have very small amplitude at normal incidence or at zero offset, and decrease, and the amplitude become dominated with negative amplitudes. The third class will have negative amplitude, and this negative amplitude increase in the sense of magnitude, but in sense of direction it's decrease, increase with the angle of incidence. So if now I am making, now we return back to CMB, normal move out stacking. So now for the first one, if I am making a stacking, I have amplitude from all these angles, which means that I have positive and the negative values. So I'm expecting at the end to end with, after stacking, to end up with smaller amplitude. Why smaller amplitude? Because I have different polarity, different signs. So when I add these values, the net value will become small. But for this case, we have the amplitudes at zero offset very small, and then becomes large at negative. So after stacking, we will have negative amplitude. We'll have relatively. If we are here until 10, say, we may have positive amplitude. But for class 3, we have all negative. We have no reverse in polarity due to stacking. Okay? This what this graph described to us. This graph is also relative or related to the previous, but it shows the fractional change, the change in amplitude for all of the classes we have, for class 1 and class 2 and class 3. Class 1, I have high impedance sand, so I'm expecting to belong to start by high amplitude at zero offset, and the amplitude decrease with angle of incidence. Now here we have the stacked section. And this stacked section, you can see that now I have this, the reflection, but at this part, the amplitude is dimmed. Okay? Dimmed due to the effect of far angle or long angle reflections. And this far angle reflections is related to negative amplitude. The result is that we have lower amplitude here, although in this part we have high amplitude. The dim out is caused by change in polarity with offset of the Hartshorne reflection. This Hartshorne is a productive unit for gas in the United States. Further illustration, we have here the change of VP. You see, we have VP increasing at Hartshorne, so we have high impedance here, and also we have increase in VS or also at Hartshorne. And then this is the offset, the amplitude versus offset near Hartshorne, and then this is the stacked version. Okay?
Okay.
Yes?
When you put the polarity, will it change from positive and flip back to negative?
Yes. The last word?
Yeah, but we can't see the change, right? Because I think it's still the same direction, although it's dimming.
I mean not a change in polarity here. It's dimming, meaning that the net stacking of amplitude is small. Because I am stacking traces with different polarities. Now the amplitudes has different polarities. You see here we have the farthest reflection, or the reflections with high offset has reverse in polarity. Okay? I feel like you are not following me. Maybe I'm not delivering the information well. So I'll return back. Here for the class 1, we have high impedance. High impedance means at theta equals 0, I have, say, reflection coefficient equal 1. Okay? So, perfect reflection. When the angle of incidence increase, the reflection of coefficient decrease. Until certain angle, the reflection coefficient become 0 or near to 0. After this point, the reflection coefficient become negative. Negative means that the amplitude in the reverse direction. When I gather these traces in CMB gather and then apply NMO and migration and so on, I will end up with number of traces in positive direction and the number other traces in negative direction. In case I have high negative amplitude, I will end up with negative polarity at some points. In case I have the positive amplitude is higher than the negative one, I will have positive amplitude but in lower proportion compared to others. So what is the situation here? Here we have high amplitudes due to the presence of the effect of gas. So it's clear here that the amplitude is very high, positive in positive direction. When I'm here, the amplitude is dimmed. Dimmed means lowered. Lowered due to the effect of the negative polarities I have. So the amplitude here is less. And this part can be identified as a place for gas production. Okay? We will have discussion at the end to summarize and to give you also the precaution that must be taken into consideration when dealing with AVO and when dealing with modeling in general. This was still now in class 1. This is the 3 adjacent CMB gathers that show the polarity change associated with the Hartshorne gas sand reflector. Okay? So we have here, see the polarity here positive, and then at this point it becomes negative. And afterwards, it returned to be positive again. The same situation here. Positive, and then negative, and then positive again. And also this one. Okay? Move further or... So this is the migrated section for now we are in class 2. This is migrated stacked section that traverse Miocene gas sand in the Brazos offshore area in Gulf of Mexico. The reflector of interest is this one, nearly at 2.1 seconds. A sketch for the geology that we have shale from the above and bottom sealing the sand, and the sand we have two parts here. We have wet sand. Wet sand means water saturated, and also we have gas sand. Our intention is to define this part. as you can see here, this is a gathering for, and this, of course, this is the theoretical one, for 0 meter offset, 1,524 meter offset, 3,048 meter offset, and then the stack section. As you see, we have nearly no change in magnitude at zero offset compared with about 1500. Also, we have no change. But when we arrive at 3000, we find that we have high amplitude here, and the amplitude dims away, dims out at these traces. The stack version give no sign or very few, very small change in amplitude. So this is synthetic model. And plotting the amplitude with the degree, now we have this time. This panel represent, or this axis represent the amplitude, and this is the angle of incidence. As you see, the amplitudes at smaller angles are very small. Can see, cannot detect here, but when we arrived at higher angle, you'll find that you have high amplitudes here. In class 3, we have negative impedance, which means that the sand have impedance Z1 less than the impedance of the shell. So this part represent the target or the reflector we are looking for. Again, we can see how the amplitude change. It's nearly the same, but small change is observed for the between the smaller angles to the wider angles. So, using this together with yesterday's example, we can use FEO to define the situation or to define the fluid and lithologic contents in certain oil field and soil, in certain oil field system. So, what counts for certain place or certain sites cannot be attributed to other sites. So for each site, we have to apply the work, we have to apply the analysis to project and to find the relation between seismicity or seismic parameters like amplitude and refraction index with the lithology and fluid content. What I mean is that somebody may say I have invented medicine that can cure every disease, and of course this man is a liar, because even for the same disease, you will have some persons cure using certain medication, while others not. So doctors usually discover the parameters and the personality of each patient and then give him the proper medication. This means that when we are going to work in modeling, in whether in ordinary modeling, tomography, and also AVO, we have to keep in our mind that we have some limitations for all softwares, for all algorithms we are using. For example, here we are observing that we have risk. Not always the dimmed amplitudes resulted or is a sign of class 1. Not always the bright amplitudes or the bright anomaly is representing or is a sign for class 3. It's not that way, and it's everything should be taken case by case. So what to do if I am going to work and I have this risk that I am not having a schema that can be applied to all situations? We have some steps we can follow. First, we include AVO attribute analysis in geographic areas that have good track record, like much of the Gulf of Mexico and North Sea. So AVO can be applied to area where I have plenty. You have any question? Okay. Where I have plenty of information. I have well logs, I have seismic, and I have also core samples. So I have many information. At this point, I can use AVO in this geographic location. Why? Because all the constituents, the lysologic and the other parameters like the fluid content, I have some idea about. I can model. If I don't have such information, I have to be very cautious. So I cannot apply seismic for areas, for blind areas, and be quite sure that this reflector or this part of reflector is a gas trap or hydrocarbon trap, unless I have full information about the area. Model the expected AVO signature from several wells in the area. So I'm now returning to wells. I have to use well logs to make sure or to model this, and then use these models as a schema for the AVO to compare with the model, or to compare with the theoretical model. Three, use those model results to guide your efforts in processing or reprocessing. The model you have from the wells, you have to use in processing, and sometimes after processing and after interpretation, you will discover some discrepancy and some error, some artifact, and then you return back to make reprocessing. At this point, you can use or you may use the AVO models obtained from the well log data. Prepare special purpose AVO displays from your seismic data to screen for hydrocarbon anomalies based on your model. So you will put some measure of the expected hydrocarbon anomalies in your model, in your area. And final one is to interpret your data with an understanding of what to look for and what to avoid. So after having all information, after having all limitations and understanding all the limitations from well logs and so on, now you have good idea about the area, you can apply your result for interpretation, and you can to some sort of confidence say, okay, this one may represent gas sand or may not. This part could be oil bearing or not. It's not just taking the data, put the data into the computer and then have the output. Finally, we have to consider some points regarding the project area. First, do the data exhibit bright spots or other attribute anomalies? If so, then take a look at the data in the BRIESTACK domain to help validate the interpretation. So after you made normal move out, after you made gather, normal move out, stacking, now you find your section contains bright spots or dimmed spots. The first thing to do is to return to BRIESTACK to return the original, the common shot record, and see the amplitudes, whether it exhibits really such thing or not. Maybe this is a problem due to migration, like distortion, or you made some error during the choice of velocity or so. So if you return back to the original data and compare, you may have information and confidence about the anomalies you have. Then have others used AVO in this area in the past? Do you have one? If you have one who applied and have experience in the area, most of the Gulf Coast, onshore and offshore, has published the track record of AVO examples. Actually, we are not going to call somebody. Please, I am working in Sarawak and I want your help in AVO. No. What we are doing is we go for literature, we go for, say, Science Direct, IEEE, all libraries, and look for those who applied and published AVO articles. Also for the oil industry, there is big bodies like SEG. You can also look for the library of SEG for those who published work in your area, and you are going to use their work as a guide for yours. Why? Because they applied AVO, and this AVO is verified by drilling and so on. So if there is some problem and some errors they fell in, you mustn't fall in the same error. So now you can avoid such error and look for yourself for another type of errors. Okay? Have the data been migrated with an amplitude preserving? And this is very important. BRIESTACK algorithm. Because if we are not dealing with amplitude, it will be meaningless to speak about AVO. If not, consider having it done before commencing work beyond the synthetic modeling stage. Because if I am not taking amplitude into consideration, so I cannot apply AVO for seismic section with no correction for amplitude. No, with the amplitude is not taken into consideration. So it's very important to migrate with amplitude. So this describes that. If I'm going to use kinematic or only travel time migration, I will not be able to apply AVO. So to be able to apply AVO or any other scheme, any other attributes that is related to amplitudes, I must have the amplitudes taken into consideration in building the cross section. Because if there is error in amplitude, you cannot. Suppose for those who have, say, diabetes, and they go to make analysis, when they go to the laboratory, they said, okay, we cannot take any samples now. You have to be fasting for, say, 9 hours or 7 hours, whatever, so that other effect is not here, because when you eat something, the amount, the percentage of sugar and so on in your body increase. So we want you to measure your sugar in your blood without the effect of it. So if it's not taken into consideration, this like limitations, so what you are doing with migration without taking amplitude into consideration is nonsense or useless. Then, am I drilling an anomaly near the top of overpressure? Recent experience suggests that the top of overpressure is a site of complex and problematic AVO when you have area with overpressure from gas. Is the target in an interval where the sands are faster than shales, slower than shales? The relative interval velocity of sand is nearby, and nearby wells can provide a quick estimate of the type of anomaly to look for. Meaning that we have the sand and we have the shale. Regardless of the fluid content, we are looking for velocity and density. So, for density, the change in density for the Earth's material is small, but the big change should be in velocity. So, if the sand is higher than the shale, then we can estimate the reflection coefficient to be positive if the ray come from sand to shale, or negative if it's coming from shale to sand. If it is reverse, so it will be, the polarity will also be reversed. So we have to get an idea about the velocity of the shale and the sand in order to determine the classes we are dealing with. So finally, I would like to point out some important points for you, because now you are going to meet your career, and some of you have already got work. Many people I met already thought that the software can think for them, can solve problems for them. And this is a big problem, and I hope you remove this from your mind. The software, whatever it is, whatever, how advanced it is a tool. The tool cannot work by itself, but you are the one who are using these tools to produce something. So if you are using your tool well, you will produce good output. If you are relying on your tool only and you have no skill, so the output will be catastrophe. Okay? So please don't think that the software will do everything, but you have to look for, first choose good input parameters, control parameters, and then look for the output. If the output is logic, and if the output is justified by other means like well logs, like geology, so it's okay. But if it is not, and if it is not in accordance with the basic geologic principles, so I have to reevaluate again and again until I arrive at point with accordance. Because after all, we are working in geologic system. So we cannot, we are not working in the ether, we are not looking in a free space, no, we are looking in rocks, and these rocks is deposited according to certain laws, and the relation between the rocks are also following certain laws. So, please don't expect that the software will think for you, and don't make all your trust in the software, because sometimes you will find yourself helpless when somebody criticize your work and say, oh, you made a big and fatal mistake.